Hi viewers, welcome to our channel Dissection of Human Body. In this video we are going to discuss about the anatomy of nose and paranasal air sinuses. My colleague Dr. Aparna Muralidharan will discuss about it. Over to her.
Hello viewers, today we are going to see the features of nose and paranasal air sinuses. So first let us see the features of nose. Nose, as you can see on this model, is made of an external nose that you can see on the face and an internal nose or nasal cavity that starts from this opening here, which is called as anterior nares or nostril. So what is the shape of nose? External nose is a pyramidal structure which is seen on the face. This external nose consists of an attached end. The upper end is attached. This is called as the root of the nose, and a lower free rounded end, which is called as tip or apex of the nose. The tip or the apex is connected posteriorly to a structure which is called as columella, which represents the lower free margin of the nasal septum, which is covered by fibrofatty connective tissue. Present on either side of the columella, we have the anterior opening, which is called as the anterior nares or nostrils that lead into the nasal cavity. Now, what constitutes the external nose? Connecting the root to the tip of the nose is a straight end, which is rounded in contour. This is called as dorsum of the nose. Diverging from the dorsum on either side is the lateral wall of the external nose. The lower part is mobile and rounded and forms two wing-like projections called as the ala of the nose. So what constitutes the external nose? External nose is made of a skeletal framework. This skeletal framework is made of a bony framework proximally and a cartilaginous framework distally. So first let us see the bones that form the skeletal part of the external nose. The bones that form the skeletal part of the external nose are mainly the nasal bones, frontal process of the maxilla, and the nasal part of the frontal bone. The lower part of the external nose, as you can see here, is made of cartilages. The major cartilages that form the skeletal part of external nose are anterior edge of the septal cartilage in the region of the dorsum, upper and lower lateral nasal cartilages here, and the alar cartilages here. Starting from the anterior nares leading into is the nasal cavity. So now let us see the features of the nasal cavity in the real specimen. To see the features in the nasal cavity, we have taken a sagittal section of the head and neck. The sagittal section of the head and neck reveals the interior of the nasal cavity. So the nasal cavity begins anteriorly from the nostril and it communicates posteriorly in this region with the nasopharynx through an opening called as the posterior nasal aperture or the choana. The nasal cavity has a roof, a floor, a medial wall which has been removed here, and a lateral wall which is seen as an irregular surface here. This specimen shows the medial wall or the nasal septum. The nasal septum divides the nasal cavity into two halves. The nasal septum is usually deflected to one side, which is called as deviated nasal septum. First, let us see the structures that form the roof of the nasal cavity. So as you can see here, this is the anterior sloping part of the roof, this is the intermediate horizontal part of the roof, and this is the posterior sloping part of the roof of nasal cavity. The anterior sloping part is formed mainly by the frontal and the nasal bones, so this is also called as the frontonasal part. The intermediate part is formed by the cribriform plate of the ethmoid, so it is called as the ethmoid part, and the posterior part is formed by the body of the sphenoid, and so this is called as the sphenoid part. The floor of the nasal cavity, as you can see here, is a structure that separates the nasal cavity above from the oral cavity below. So this structure is nothing but the palate, which you already know. In the anterior two-third, it is formed by the palatine process of the maxilla, and in the posterior one-third, it is formed by the horizontal plate of the palatine bone. Here we have the medial wall of the nasal cavity, which is also called as the nasal septum. So this structure here is the nasal septum. You can see this shiny surface. This is a mucous membrane that is covering the nasal septum. So to see the skeletal framework of the nasal septum, we need to strip off this mucous membrane. So here I have stripped off the mucoperiosteum and the mucoperichondrium to see the structures that are forming the nasal septum. So the major bones that form the nasal septum are, one, this triangular piece of thin bone. This is called as the vomer. The vomer articulates above with the rostrum of the body of the sphenoid to form the schindylicis joint. Above the vomer, this midline part is formed by the perpendicular plate of ethmoid. So these are the two major bones that form the nasal septum. In the anterior part, the nasal septum is mobile and is made of cartilage. The cartilaginous part of the nasal septum is formed by this quadrangular piece of cartilage called as the septal cartilage. In addition, we also have the septal process of lower lateral nasal cartilage. If you can see here, in the anterior part where it communicates with the nostrils to the external atmosphere, it is covered by skin. This forms a part of the nasal cavity called as vestibule. The remaining part is covered by mucous membrane. Nasal septum is a highly vascular structure. In the anteroinferior quadrant of the nasal septum, somewhere in this area, there is a large plexus of arteries happening. The anterior ethmoidal, the sphenopalatine, greater palatine vessels, and the septal branch of the facial artery, anastomose in this point. This area is also called as Little's area, and the plexus that anastomoses here is formed, that is called as Kieselbach's plexus. This is the most common site of bleeding from the nose on the anterior aspect, that is called as anterior epistaxis. This can happen even in small trivial injuries, and it is more common among children. Now what you are seeing is the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. In contrast to the medial wall of the nasal septum, we can see that the lateral wall is highly irregular because of some projections and depressions in between them. The lateral wall of the nasal cavity is also made of bones and cartilages. The major bones that form the lateral wall are these projections. These are called as the superior and middle concha, which is a part of the labyrinth of the ethmoid bone, and this is a separate piece of bone called as the inferior nasal concha. Apart from this, we have some accessory bones like frontal bone and lacrimal bone that contribute to the formation of anterior aspect of the lateral wall. In this posterior aspect, the lateral wall is formed by medial pterygoid plate of the sphenoid bone and the perpendicular plate of palatine bone. Let us see the parts of the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. So this is the nostril, and the moment the air enters through the nostril, the area with which the air first comes in contact, as you can see here, it is darkly pigmented, and this area, which is lined by skin, is called as vestibule. This area contains fine hairs that helps to filter the inhaled air. This is called as vibrissae. The vestibule leads on to a mucous membrane lined space, and this area is demarcated by a mucocutaneous ridge called as limen nasi. Beyond the limen nasi, we have a depression which is lined by the mucous membrane of the nose. This area is called as atrium. The atrium is in turn limited above by a small mucous elevation called as agger nasi. So this is the anterior part of the nasal cavity. The intermediate large part of the nasal cavity, as you can see here, and as I've already told, contains so many elevations. The elevations are this one, this small one. This is the superior nasal concha. This one is a middle nasal concha, and this larger one is the inferior nasal concha. So please remember that the superior and middle concha are part of the ethmoid bone, whereas the inferior concha is a separate bone. Because of these shelf-like projections, we have some spaces created underneath and between them. So the space present beneath the inferior concha is called as inferior meatus. And the space between the middle and the inferior concha is called as a middle meatus. Between the superior concha and middle concha, it is called as superior meatus. And the area above the superior concha is called as sphenoethmoid recess. In some individuals, above the superior concha, there might be an additional concha called as supreme concha. Now let us see the structures that open into these meatuses. So first we will start with inferior meatus. So this inferior meatus receives in its anterior aspect a single opening. This opening is the inferior opening of a duct called nasolacrimal duct. This duct starts from the lacrimal sac present in the lacrimal fossa. From there, the tears are carried down from the conjunctival sac into the nasal cavity. This explains why we get nasal discharge when we cry. Several structures open into the middle meatus. So, to see the structures opening into the middle meatus, when I lift the middle concha, you can see a rounded elevation. This rounded elevation present in the middle meatus is called as bulla ethmoidalis. Bulla ethmoidalis is created due to the middle ethmoidal air cells. If you can see in front, below and behind the bulla, there is a deep depression which is semilunar in shape. This depression is called as hiatus semilunaris. If you trace the hiatus semilunaris forward, it passes through a narrow gap. This gap receives the frontal sinus from above. So this is the frontal sinus, which is an air-filled sinus present between the outer and inner tables of the frontal bone. This channel that communicates frontal sinus with infundibulum is called as the frontonasal duct. So these are the features present in the middle meatus. Let us see the structures that open into this area. To see the structures opening into the middle meatus, I have removed a small part of the middle concha. You can still see the bulla ethmoidalis. So this is the bulla ethmoidalis and this is the hiatus semilunaris. So on the summit of the bulla ethmoidalis, you can see two openings. These are the openings of the middle ethmoidal air cells. So if you remember, bulla ethmoidalis is created because of the middle ethmoidal air cells. So the openings on its summit are the openings of middle ethmoidal air cells. You can see an opening in the hiatus semilunaris. This is the opening of the maxillary sinus. So in the hiatus semilunaris, you can see the opening of the maxillary sinus. If you trace in front, as I had already told, the anterior funnel-shaped part of the hiatus semilunaris leads into the frontonasal duct. So this is the frontonasal duct. You can see the tip of my probe present in the frontal sinus. So the infundibulum or the frontonasal duct receives the frontal air sinus. The floor of the infundibulum also receives the anterior ethmoidal air cells. So the middle meatus receives the middle ethmoidal air cells in the bulla ethmoidalis, maxillary air sinus in the hiatus semilunaris, frontonasal duct receives the frontal air sinus, and the floor of the ethmoidal infundibulum receives the anterior ethmoidal air cells. Above the middle concha and below the superior concha is a space. This space is called a superior meatus. The superior meatus receives the posterior ethmoidal air cells. And as I've already told, the area above the superior concha is called a sphenoethmoidal recess. The sphenoethmoidal recess receives this sinus. This sinus present in the body of the sphenoid bone is called as a sphenoid air sinus. So the sphenoethmoidal recess receives the sphenoid air sinus. This is a coronal section taken through the nasal cavity. Here you can see the midline nasal septum, and this is the individual halves of the nasal cavity. This is the lateral wall of the nasal cavity. The hanging projections are the conchae. So this large concha is the inferior nasal concha, and this one is the middle concha. Here you can see two large mucous membrane lined pyramidal spaces. This is what is called as the maxillary air sinus. It is present within the bone, that is maxilla. And this is the frontal air sinus, which is also mucous membrane lined, and it is present within the frontal bone. So in this section we can see the frontal air sinuses, the ethmoidal air sinuses present within the labyrinth of the ethmoid bone, and the two maxillary air sinuses present within the maxilla. The air sinuses that you can see in this section are the frontal air sinus and the sphenoid air sinus. These air sinuses are formed because of pneumatization of the bones around the nasal cavity, creating pneumatic bones. The pneumatic bones that communicate with the nasal cavity, resulting in the formation of paranasal air sinuses, are frontal air sinus within the frontal bone, sphenoid air sinus within the sphenoid bone, maxillary air sinus within maxilla, anterior, middle and posterior ethmoidal air sinuses within the ethmoidal labyrinth. Thank you.